Hey friends, Andrew here, hope you're well. macOS Sequoia is now released and available to download, and so in today's video, I've come up with a list of 10 settings you want to change right away once you update your macOS to Sequoia, or after you get a new shiny MacBook. The very first macOS Sequoia setting to change is making sure the new rotating Wi-Fi addresses feature is switched on. It's a great way, an easy way to boost privacy. To do this, open System Settings, which, by the way, you will notice when clicking System Settings, it will now open the General tab by default, then click Wi-Fi, then Details, and under Private Wi-Fi Address, select the new Rotating option. Switching this on will rotate your Wi-Fi address from time to time, which reduces the chance of your Wi-Fi address being tracked, and it's an easy way to help increase privacy. While we're managing your Mac security right here, Apple has updated the Privacy and Security tab in Sequoia with a cleaner layout, and here are some essential security settings to change. First, turn off significant locations tracking, go into Location Services, then scroll down to System Services, and then disable significant locations here. This will stop your Mac from tracking all your movements and places you've recently been to, but this setting won't impact other location services like Apple Maps. Let's also scroll down and enable the Show Location icon setting here. This will show you exactly when your system or an app pings your location. Then while we're also here, if you prefer to browse more anonymously and don't like targeted ads, you can also limit ad tracking here. So go back out and scroll all the way down to Apple Advertising and disable personalized ads here. If you prefer to be delivered targeted ads tailored to your account information and you enjoy offers tailored to your browsing history, you can always leave this toggled on. The next thing you'll want to set up on your Mac is yet another important security feature, and it's Rapid Security Response. Go into General and then Software Update, then click the info icon next to Automatic Updates, and right here, enable Install Security Responses and System Files. This was actually an important feature originally released in macOS Ventura, and once you've turned this on, you'll get automatic security updates on the go in the background without even requiring a system restart. It, of course, doesn't replace full software updates, but this setting allows Apple to quickly install updates on your Mac in the background to help protect you from newly found security breaches. The next new Sequoia setting you'll want to set up is custom headphone profiles to boost the sound profile of compatible headphones. Go into Accessibility, scroll down to Audio, then down to Headphone Accommodations. There's now a new custom audio setup button and audio tuning. Here you can play sample sounds and tune it to your exact liking. And then it does make a nice subtle difference in the soundstage based off the short testing that I had with it. This is especially great if you have hearing deterioration, and you can actually upload an audiogram test and your Mac will boost frequencies that your ear has lost. So it corrects sounds to what it should sound like based on your hearing profile. It's a pretty great feature. The next new setting is great if you want to activate custom functions with your voice. It's called Vocal Shortcuts, and it's also featured in iOS 18. So still in Accessibility Settings, scroll down to Vocal Shortcuts, then click Setup. Select the shortcut you want to set up. Let's say we want to, quickly screenshot and airdrop it to another device. Select that option, give it a phrase like screen drop, then just say the phrase three times. Screen drop, screen drop, screen drop. Now I can get that multi-step function within just a single phrase by saying screen drop. It's really useful. One of the biggest new Sequoia features is the new password app, which is Apple's attempt to take on apps like 1Pass or LastPass. And while after using it for over a month now, it's actually a decent free integrated password manager. To set it up, go into the Passwords app, click Passwords in the menu bar, then Settings, or you can always use the shortcut Command plus comma to take you there. It's also worth enabling Show Passwords in the menu bar here for quick access when we want to create passwords or logins. And it's as simple as that. All you just need to do now is fill out your logins. And this native app syncs with iCloud across devices. And if you also use Windows devices like I do, you can also access the Passwords app through the iCloud for Windows app from the Microsoft Store. Next is Windows tiling. This is yet another new native Mac feature that will likely and unfortunately put some paid apps out of business like Magnet and Rectangle. So to turn this on, under Desktop and Dock Settings, scroll all the way down to the new tiling settings and switch these on. Now you can either drag and tile your windows like so, or hover on the green window button and you'll find the new tiling options. Pro tip here as well, if you hold down the Option key and hover over the green dot, you'll find even more hidden tiling options. I found the tiling animations to be even more fluid and pleasant than the paid apps. And yeah, Apple is on a tear when it comes to natively integrating paid apps. Rest in peace, Magnet and Rectangle. The Notes app has also got new superpowers. In the menu bar, there's a new record audio button which activates the Mac's microphone to take notes and transcribes it for you. One of the best use cases for this, in my opinion, is for meetings. You can activate this feature during a call in a meeting, and it'll transcribe the entire meeting and even summarize it via Apple Intelligence or locally on Notes. There's also finally the ability to create collapsible sections and to highlight text too. A little late to the game, but hey, better late than never, I guess. Now, iPhone mirroring is one of the coolest features of macOS Sequoia. To activate it, just make sure that both your iPhone and Mac are signed into Apple account. And yep, Apple ID is now called Apple account on Sequoia. Then open the new iPhone mirroring app in the dock. It'll look like this. And then the app will then trigger the connection, unlock it via the Mac, and just like that, you've got remote access to your iPhone from your Mac. This has held up so well during my time with it, even when I was testing the beta version of macOS Sequoia, and you can finally access all the iPhone-only apps right from your Mac, even if the iPhone is in a completely different room. So the next one is a fun one. Apple's introduced a new set of wallpapers and dynamic screensavers, and they're definitely worth checking out. So right click on the desktop and click change wallpaper. And you can see here a new Macintosh retro dynamic wallpaper set. You can customize the colors here and you can set it as a dynamic screensaver too. These font sets are a throwback to a time when macOS was simply just called system software and competed with classic MS-DOS in the mid-80s, if anyone remembers that. And I love that Apple has taken a fun spin on their wallpapers. And then, of course, there is Apple Intelligence, which is set to transform our Macs. If you want to see my full video on Apple Intelligence, be sure to subscribe. And if you found this video useful, drop a like and also drop a Macintosh in the comments. And I'll give it a like myself for making it to the end of this video. And click here to check out my favorite list of must-have free Mac apps. As always, thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.